Good morning and welcome to Eagle's Nest Live for AHS Morning News. Hello, I'm Sophia.
And I'm Macy, and we are here to provide you with the news for today, Monday, January 28th.
Up in the morning and out to school, the teacher is teaching the golden rule. American history and practical math, you study them hard and hoping to pass. Working your fingers right down to the bone, goes the bell. The cook in the lunchroom's ready to sell. You're lucky if you can find a seat. You're fortunate if you have time to eat. Back in the classroom, open your books. Keep it, the teacher don't know how mean she looks.
The Apollo girls bowling team is headed back to state championship for the third time out of 4 years of having the bowling program. The Lady Eagles bowlers finished the Region 1 tournament in Paducah Saturday as the runner-ups, up losing to Barron County in the finals. And the boys bowling team ended their season Saturday, finishing in the top eight at Region. Congratulations, bowlers, and best of luck in state competition.
Any student in 9th through 11th grades who are interested in attending the Empower Kentucky Youth Conference this summer needs to see Mrs. McCarty for an application. She is in room 438, and applications are due by February 6th. This free conference is a great leadership opportunity and would be great to have listed on resumes and applications.
Today is recycling day for the 100s, 200s, and front office areas. Please place your blue recycling bins outside your classroom door at the start of 4th period today.
Go for like a good 5 seconds. 3, 4, 5.
All right. All right, everybody. It's Trevor again. I'm here to say Dance Flu was amazing last night. We set a record for attendance. We had 275 members of the Eagle family and other area schools attend. So just go ahead in your classrooms, give yourselves a round of applause if you came, even if you didn't. We appreciate all the support we had all throughout the year. I know you might be tired of hearing Dance Blue, but we're not tired talking to you. So, and I also have some announcements to make. For best costume from last night, the Baskin-Robbins Ice Cream Group. And for the most spirited dancer, it's Mariano McKenzie. So you guys won some awards. Go to Ms. Jarbo to claim your awards. Once again, this is Trevor. Thank you so much for all your support throughout the year. Everybody in Dance Room, myself, really appreciate it.
Cabaret night is quickly approaching. The Love and Heartache Cabaret is scheduled for February 13th at 6 p.m. in the auditorium. Tickets are $5 at the door. Please email Miss April Berry if you would like to perform at Cabaret. All acts performing are required to audition for Miss Berry before the Cabaret night.
Attention girls, do you dream of being an automotive mechanic, electrician, welder, HVAC tech, or a Magnus? Ever had someone tell you that you could not do it? You can do anything you set your mind to and be anything you want to. On Thursday, March 7th, OCTC will be hosting a dinner. The dinner is free and features for super middleweight boxer champion and Bryant. Stop by Guinness to sign up.
The Apollo tennis teams will have drills this Saturday from 11 until 12:30 at center court. Inside courts will cost $5 for each player.
Today we are on regular schedule and first period is 10.
This afternoon, Liza Vincent will sign her national letter of intent and announce where she will continue her academic and athletic career at the post-secondary level. Please join Liza in the celebration at 4 o'clock this afternoon in the Commons area.
Burns Middle School? I don't know.
I have no idea.
My first teaching job was at Davis County High School.
'57.
Close.
1963.
Close.
1969.
He got it!
Apollo High School was first started in 1969.
What incident happened that took out the dome?
Ooh, I have no idea.
I don't know, was it like a storm or something? I can't remember.
A tornado.
What current male teacher was a cheerleader here at Apollo High School?
Well, I tend to think that Coach Head was a little more on the cheerleader side, but I don't know.
Mr. Owen.
Mm-mm.
Mr. Phelan, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Mr. Phelan was an Apollo cheerleader. And darn good at it, I might add.
Who was the first principal at Apollo High School?
I have no clue.
I have no idea. Oh, gosh. Mallory, I don't know.
Well, Apollo here was 78. I was down in Tuscaloosa, Alabama, coaching the Black Bears to national fame. I'm going to say Rex Chapman's daddy, which I know is wrong.
The first Apollo High School principal, I believe it was Frank List.
When Apollo was originally built, what purpose did the auditorium fill?
I don't know.
I have no clue.
Honestly, I have no idea.
So when Apollo was first built, long before I was a student here, the auditorium was actually the gym.
If you're kicking yourself for not signing up for the track, you are in luck because it is 100% not too late to join. If you're interested in being in Apollo's track and field team this year or just have a question about the sport, stop by and see Coach Schulte in room 200.
Seniors, don't forget Life Touch will be here today to take your pictures in caps and gowns. Picture Makeup Day is this Friday, February 1st. If you have any questions, see Mr. Poff.
For today's lunch, you have a choice of chicken fettuccine in the Global Fare line, Salisbury steak or pork and gravy in the Mama's Kitchen line, chef salad or sub in the sub line, and several choices in the sandwich line, and pudding is the dessert of the day.
We would like to wish all students good luck in their afternoon school activities. Thank you and have a great day.
Good morning, Eagles. I wanted to start today with a couple of announcements. First, very proud of the work and the dedication that goes into the Dance Blue event. It's more than just one day. I know it's a year's worth of hard work. Very proud of the leadership and the dedication of all the students that participate. Good work. Keep it up. And also, very proud, we had a moment this past weekend. We have region champions in our building, actually one region champion and others that competed in bowling. I wanted to give a shout-out for fourth-place regional winner, Molly Statz, second-place or runner-up, Teresa Rickardson, and your region champ is Emma Workman. These young ladies will be going and competing in state here in about a week or so, so congratulations to them. Also, Braden West. Everybody knows Braden. I always tease him by saying he's the mayor of Apollo. Braden West is going to be having some surgery this week. He may be getting his tonsils taken out, starting out with a scope tomorrow. So today's his last day before he has that work done. If you want to stop by and offer him some well wishes, send him your prayers. Again, Braden West, we wish him the best. As far as birthdays go today on this January 28th, Brady Gray, Meg Zuber, both celebrating birthdays. Let's make it a great day in Eagle Nation.
Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.